JBTV is being brought to you in part by Crow's Nest Music, the collector's choice.
Hello, I'm Joe. And are you going to go over
here? And I'm Scott. That's me.
And then we go over here. Hi, I'm Jerry Bryant. Coming up next right here is JBTV, the most awesome television show, because we still play the music. And we haven't sold out to any corporate sponsors.
That's right. And if he does, you know what's going to happen?
He'll bust sell out. He'll get lots of money.
He'll make some cash.
Yeah, but, you know. So anyhow, on the show, Local H, coming up next right here, right now. JBTV. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Scott.
And I'm Joe from Local H, and you are watching
JBTV, the television show where tonight it's live in concert, exclusively all Local H, because you guys are so good, you deserve so much airtime.
You flatter us, hey, that's so nice.
Send this to MTV.
Oh, that's so nice.
Played with them.
Hey, they copy everything we do anyhow, so, you know.
Yeah, I'm done making videos. Right now, let's say we are done making videos.
Make never say anything, because it all comes back in my face.
Yeah. Make some for JBTV, because we'll play them. And there are other video shows around the country that play your stuff.
Well, we should just do the live videos. I think I'm down with live videos.
We're going to shoot our live videos. Our anytime live shows, and then that'll be a video. That's it.
Yeah, anytime you want.
Yeah, there you go.
Actually, I thought of a great thing. You know, the band would just be in one place, and you're on the internet in 3D, like hologram. Mm. So you never go anywhere. It's like, okay, now we're beaming to Los Angeles.
It's like, you know, like the country artists, they like build a place, they just build their own theater, and everyone comes out to see them.
Exactly.
And that's, it's pretty progressive. I kind of like that. That's all right.
So we're going to have a whole complex, you know, food, drink, a little concert hall, a multi-track recording studio, and all that. So anyhow, on this edition of JBTV, all live in concert, Local H. And enjoy right here exclusively for you on JBTV on Channel 62.
Cool.
Thanks.
I think I saw you down there on the right.
Yeah, he was down there in the...
Yeah. Pointing the camera.
Yeah, and that's the first time ever anybody said hi to me from stage that I've never met, so... thank you.
The Scott's no speaker. Oh, okay.
Yeah. Right at the beginning there, so, you know.
So I never even knew you guys were over here.
Yeah. This is it. Oh, okay. All right.
Oh, we don't pay. We get in and out, have fun.
Excellent. All right.
I used to live right around the corner. I never knew you were over here.
Really?
Yeah.
So you were one of our neighbors? We never ran into you ever?
Coming by, bringing you guys coffee, croissants, you know.
Borrowing videotapes and stuff.
Borrowing videotapes, yeah.
I missed that show last night. Let me check it out. Yeah, we saw the Jesus Lizard thing. If you could play like some Jesus Lizard live stuff.
Oh, yeah, you like them?
Cool. Yeah,
they're great. David, he is so great. He goes out there and does these stupid things. Like, he hit himself with a mic stand on one of the shows, and he had this big lump, you know. I felt so sorry for him, but he didn't feel it.
He's singing through the whole crowd. He's
just like, you know, like most bands, they'll, like, be doing the show, and then at the end, they'll jump out in the crowd. He's like this, bam, I'm in the crowd, and that's it. You know, that's how it goes.
Yeah, and he's got, like, the longest mic cord, and it just keeps going and going and going.
They're quite a band. They're amazing.
Yeah.
Segue into the rock.
Yeah, the Jesus Lizard, live exclusively for you right here on JBTV, your alternative show from downtown Chicago. So welcome.
Deformity.
Oh, you like them too?
Yeah, we did a tour with them about 4 years ago. And that's about it.
Yeah.
What else to say? That's the blind one, though. That was way before.
I can't see it because I am blind.
Are you nearsighted or farsighted?
I'm nearsighted. I can't see far away.
That's me too. And now, as you get older, you'll find that even reading, it gets to get closer and closer.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Another thing to look forward to. That's great.
That's what happens when you tour all the time and work endlessly, you know. So how was it playing to your parents last night?
They've gone to a lot of our shows. You know?
So it wasn't anything.
They're groupies.
No, I don't have to worry about it. My mom likes the F word, and so it's okay. Uh-huh. It's all right. Yeah.
So she said this while you were growing up.
What, the F word? No, actually, she would never. That would never come out of her mouth. You know, and it's just like she had a thing about it. So that's probably why.
Why it's in the song.
Yeah, why it's in every damn song we have.
Every song. What was I gonna say here? I saw. What did I see back there?
What you did last summer? Yeah, I saw
it.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
Definitely.
Okay, that's it, man. Are you going to play that?
What was that now?
What Scott just said, what you did last summer, part two. You got that?
What was that?
A movie.
Oh, a movie? Yeah. Oh, we don't show movies here.
I'm joking.
We only play music.
Okay, cool.
And more of it, you know.
I used to watch JBTV all the time, but now I don't have cable.
Oh, no, but we're on a real TV station, yeah, but, Channel 62.
Okay, but I have satellite, so I can't get...
Isn't that unequal? It's like you're going to get 500 channels, and all you get is ESPN and 20 movie channels.
They don't give you, I mean, I do have cable. I just got to plug it in, but its reception is really terrible. I mean, it's, when you come from watching satellite, the cable, it's kind of like eating generic brand, you know,
Pop-Tarts.
Cereal, Pop-Tarts or something, and going to the real deal.
Eating Toasties instead of Pop-Tarts,
right?
Exactly. Right.
What we deal with on the road.
Got to speak Joe's language.
Yeah. The Toasty Tour, 98.
It's not good. They don't like it.
So, this is a weird interview, isn't it?
Why? Because you're not, you're used to all the same stuff all the time.
Yeah, I'm used to the same stuff, so this is on, now we feel like we're on the spot here.
No, you don't have to be on the spot. This is your whole show. You can do whatever you want, so play all the videos you guys like, you know?
See what we're gonna do.
Are you guys going to play that?
Oh, the old JBLs.
Oh, these are the old 43.
Yeah, these things.
These have got to be 20-some years old.
Yeah, those things kick out, though.
Oh,
What have you had to replace so far?
The big 15s, because the insulation along the side keeps getting old, and it, like, breaks out and stuff.
Brittled out, yeah.
Technical talk.
Yeah, tech talk.
Well, I go to technical talk when I run out of things, you know. Hey, you got a look weight sticker over there hiding.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's been there for so long, it's gotten covered over, so we're going to have to get some new ones.
All right, who covered it? Who's that British stuff?
I don't know, you know.
Wait, who is
Pitch Shifter, did you ever hear of them?
Oh, is it Pitch Shifter?
Yeah, they got that Genius song.
You know, I don't even see it. Oh, I
and
see
Eve
it
now. Six.
Oh,
well,
Eve
you're
Six.
You're so blind.
Eve Six got a lot of nerve to put their sticker next to ours. Are they crazy?
Well, you know.
Are you guys going to play that, porno Fig Dish video?
I already played that. That's like
I didn't see
when shirts
can
get
I see
tight.
Can I see it?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't see it.
Yeah.
You play the X-rated one?
I need to see it.
Have you? No, you haven't. You haven't played the X-rated
one. Well, I played your X-rated video years ago.
Yeah, that's what the kids said.
Yeah.
And the kids were talking about it. But the one where there's two versions. There's one that's totally X, and then there's one that's like PG-13.
Yeah, well, this one's got all the good parts covered. You know, like there's a little plant.
Right. There's one that doesn't have anything covered. And it's a little racy.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't think you were going to play it, but you know.
Yeah, but we will play Fig Dish for you.
All right.
Yeah, this is, I guess, version two. I thought I had the better version, but you know, MTV won't even play this version.
Well,
so.
See, it depends on what you like. They both have their virtues.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're both fine videos. But yeah, correct. MTV, you know, they're,
play videos.
What are they going to do? I don't think we should make videos anymore.
I don't
want to
make videos.
No. You got to make videos.
It's a waste of our time. It's a waste of our money. It's just like, you know, I don't know. What do you do?
Here.
Yeah? Well, you know, all right. But we're going to make cheaper videos.
Well, that's okay, because the music's good. Each one of you should have like a camera. Little helmet cam or something.
We should just do like live videos and stuff like that.
You know,
just something like that.
Yeah.
Just we'll just like play the stuff that like you guys recorded last night and just call it a day.
Bring video camera videos back.
You know,
quality.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Like high A kind or
yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like that Stone Temple Pilots video.
Well, they did that in the studio. That was really expensive, but they made it look cheap.
Oh, it was expensive.
Yeah, well, they did it like in a, you
those
know, probably
tricksters.
Some New York studio or something, you know, with tons of union people,
right.
Cameramen.
Well, it was, you know, there was, it had to be catering going on or something like that. And that was probably what did it, was the catering.
Well, here they are. Let's see Fig Dish right here, right now on JBTV. We have Local H in the studio. And after all these years... It's a shame that you haven't gotten here before this, but
yeah,
you know.
This is really weird. Yeah.
I don't know what's up with that. What?
I don't know.
Who do we have to hang for this? I mean,
no, we don't like pursue anybody.
Oh, you just
we just loved your music. We always played your videos, and we get like so many requests for your stuff. So
cool.
You know,
that's great.
Yeah, just for doing the show, we had like all these calls. You got to go to the show and tape them because they haven't been on yet. You
right.
know,
right.
So. I'm glad it all worked out,
cool.
You know.
Yeah.
I think a lot of kids, like, on the internet were talking about it, and, you know, they were just, like, I guess a couple of people, like, had called you or something and asked about it, and, And so there it is. It's done.
More than a couple.
Yeah. And then back when I had my access show, you know, the high five and motherfucker is the one we played, you know. But now that we're on broadcast, we can't say motherfucker anymore, you know.
Well, you know, there's I kind of like bleeps. You know, there's a good.
But it's just something about screwing with the music in any way, shape, or form that gets me upset a little, you know.
Well, I kind of like the fact that there's, you know, I mean, if you want to listen to it the way it is, you've got the record. But, I mean, we all know the FCC and we all know, you know, what words you can't say. So there's no reason to really complain about it, you know. If you want to really hear the real one, there's a record.
Mm-hmm. And a lot of them. Now, on your latest CD, you have all these cats everywhere. Are those your cats?
They're Nick's, right?
Actually, on the CD.
Yeah. I mean, like, they're, like you're sitting there, like, in your picture. Like, you just got up, you know, and you're, like, in a.
Well, they're actually neighbor's cats. Mm-hmm. I had to take care of a lot of cats at one time, and so it was around the time we did the photo shoot, so.
That was when we were living together, remember? Right. Yeah.
Right. So we just kind of, you know, borrowed all these cats and did some shots.
Uh-huh. I hope you had a couple of cat boxes.
Yeah. Well, see, I it freaks me out, cats, you know, but I didn't even know what was going on. And then he woke me up and said, you know, Scott, get up for breakfast. We're going to have Captain Crunch this morning. And so I got up and I looked around. I was like, you know, there's like, you know, cameras set up and everything. And there's like cats all over the place. And
meanwhile, he's got his paper. He's reading sports, you know, and he had to get what's going on with the Cubs. That was it, the Cubs, yeah, Sox or whatever.
You know, I can't get enough of the sports page, man. You know, I love it.
I hate sports.
I mean, he lives at Wrigley Field, you know.
Yeah, I just live there every day.
How is the parking around there? It is crazy. Like, even for the show at the Metro, you know, if it's on a night that the games are going on, you know, like, it's nowhere.
Well, you know, that's a great thing about this city is. One, you don't have to go to the game, and two, you don't have to go to the game, and then three, you can just walk and take public transportation. Uh-huh. And four, you don't have to go to the game.
Uh-huh. And you can sell those passes if you're in the neighborhood. You can get those, you know.
Oh yeah. That's right. That's right.
Yeah, a little bit of money on the side, you know, like they do with your shows. I'm sure now they're all sold out all the time.
Yeah, that's tough. But, you know, we told our manager not to stand outside and scalp, but he just won't listen to us, you know.
It's always like, gotta make a buck, you know?
Always looking for the buck. It's like, come on, you know. And then the crew gets into it. They're out there selling our tickets. It's just like, I just don't know what to do anymore.
It's like your, it's a high five. The one at the end with your, like, going for the money.
Yes.
It's like right at the end of the video, it's like, okay, everybody else got it.
What was his name? Dr. Winkles?
Dr. Winky.
Winky, whatever.
Who was that? That was the guy in the
video?
That
was the guy with the money, with the briefcase.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It was his
club and his real money. He went to the bank and got like $100,000 out of something, or $20,000 or something, and put it in his briefcase.
That wasn't fake
money. That weren't Monopoly money.
Oh, no. You know, that's against law. You can't do that. That's
Monopoly money?
No, real money. You're not supposed to show it on TV.
Really?
So, you know.
Why is that true? I heard that, but why is that?
I don't know.
We were just kidding. It's Monopoly money.
You're not supposed to have real beer on TV?
Yeah.
What is that about?
I don't know. Well, that's inside this Coke is really a beer.
Yeah, you have to drink, pretend you're drinking Coke.
Yeah, that's it.
That's what they do on Friends, right?
In France?
Yeah.
So what of your videos should we see on the show? Because it goes all the way back to 95 with Cynic. And,
Whoa, you got it all.
Hey, we've been playing your stuff before I even knew. I just thought you were great. I didn't even know you were local.
Thanks.
Really?
For a while there. I'm like going, I just love this music, and you know.
Thank you.
Play whatever you like, I guess. I mean,
we're playing everything. You're not going to get like one or two songs. I'm playing your entire catalog of videos.
Okay.
That's cool. Okay, I guess you can play that Cynic video. It's, I actually see a little shot of it right there.
A little shot of it, all queued up and ready to go.
Where I was wearing the,
that last night?
That's last night.
I can show you a little of that too.
That's last night, and that's 4 years ago.
Uh-huh.
Last night? 4 years ago. Last night, 4 years ago. It's wearing the, was that your hood?
Shirt.
Was that your hood? Yeah. So, yeah, all right. Jam that.
Okay, here it is right now. Your first video. And that was fun first doing video. That one. Did they, like, tie everything? Were you, like, scared about it? Or?
Oh, that was, like, new to the game of videos. And I'm not a video type of guy. I just hate making them. So, that one, I hate it too. But
it was our first video, and I think it shows. Yeah. Not anything against Jody, the director, or anything. It's us. I mean, you can see it in us that, you know. I mean, we still don't know what the hell we're doing with these things, but, you know.
These interviews and stuff, I just have no clue.
Yeah. You should do, like, a Roger Daltrey with these things. Oh, yeah? I just hit it. Sorry.
That'll sound good on TV.
I'm sorry.
That's not a problem.
Getting out of control.
Okay, here it is, Cynic, Local H, right here, their first video they ever made, and you're going to see it right now on JBTV. Actually, I saw it back in 95 on JBTV, but...
You'll see it again on JBTV.
So what other videos you want to see? Again, your whole show, I think... Have you ever seen our show? You must have, huh?
Yeah, I've seen your show a lot. Yeah, I haven't seen it lately because I haven't...
Like, were you watching and I played one of your videos?
No, well, I've never seen one of our videos.
Darn!
But I've seen, like,
I saw Liz Fair back in Exile in Guyville days.
You got that, like, Betty Sevier live thing that you did. That was great. I really dug that.
I remember they came down and they were so upset because no one was playing them. And they said, here we are, we're doing our music, and we can't get airplay. It's, like, the hardest thing to do.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, I think I taped some of that stuff, and it was just really good. Really good stuff.
Wow. Yeah. Legs.
Yeah, well, I mean, I taped it off your show.
That's okay.
So, what was it? It was...
That was like 20 years ago.
I forget what the song was. It was probably like, what's the first song in that first record?
What was it called? I don't know.
I don't remember either. Something. But we have it. Here it is, Betty Sevier, right now, right here on JBTV, your alternative show from downtown Chicago.
Mudhoney's playing the Metro. When is that?
Mudhoney's playing the Metro the 30th, correct?
Yes, we're in town.
We're in town. We're playing. We're doing Joan Jett. Can you play a Joan Jett video?
Oh, yeah. Joan Jett's been here.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's hot. She's like, you know, I mean, you know, still rocking after all these years and the attitude.
Joan Jett is just awesome.
Yeah. Well, let's see a Joan Jett tune.
All right.
Right here, right now on JBTV, and it's Local H's whole show. But I got to tell you, folks, we're going to have a part two with Local H because they got so many videos, like six of them, and we got like 90 minutes of a great concert, and all the stuff is great. So you'll be watching for a lot more. But here is Joan Jett on JBTV, your alternative show from downtown Chicago.
Excellent. So it'll
you
be
have
like,
any Triple Fast 20 videos?
Oh, yeah,
revved up.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I don't think I saw that one.
You did?
Yeah, Wes has got eye makeup on it and everything like that.
I didn't see it. Freak. So you have to play it that way.
He said to the video director, like, make me look weird.
Really?
Oh, that's not
or
right.
Something like that. Okay. But, yeah, Wes is playing with us, so. Mm-hmm. That was him last night playing guitar. Is he on that show?
Oh, yeah, he's in the back. The way he comes in, they, like, come and go, you know.
Right.
And you get him off stage, you know, like... As soon as they're done, what was that one instrument? There was one like an accordion. Or something.
Oh,
yeah, it's an accordion.
The AC/DC song.
Yeah, that was like really cool. It's like as soon as he's done with the last note.
Yeah, Gabe doesn't like to hang around.
No. He doesn't even like to look at the crowd. He's just like anything but the audience. You know.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
That's a shtick. You think it's shyness, but it's actually a shtick that he has perfected over the years. And he pretends to be shy, and then he gets out there, and he's like, "Gotta go." It's endearing, but it's fake. Totally fake. The guy's an animal. He gets off stage, starts drinking beer, starts kicking people, and like telling people to get out of his way. He's an animal.
Uh-huh.
He's a total animal.
The original rock attitude.
Yeah, he used to sing for Iron Maiden, but that was a long time ago. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Cool. Okay, here it is. Triple fast action, revved up. Now, at the beginning of the song, it sounds like they start the tape because it goes...
Yeah, they probably just hit the play, probably did that. Yeah, there's a lot of weird things in that record.
We don't care if the tape isn't rolling. We've already started playing.
Yeah, there's a lot of things in that record of like little like glitches and stuff and things. And that's just the kind of guy Wes is. He's a freak, as evidenced by the video.
So you can play a Cheap Trick video too if we
absolutely anything you want.
Yeah, did you record any Cheap Trick shows?
No, never have. Never even interviewed him or nothing.
Really?
No. Whoa. Again, we don't. You know, to me, the show was more like a hobby. Mm-hmm. And if anybody wants to come down and be on it, and it doesn't have to come. You don't have to come down to get your videos played.
Right.
There's no politics here. Right, it's just music. So you know.
Right. That's cool. That's cool. You guys need to like you know. Get big or something like it.
Well, we've been
TV.
Trying to, but you know, the problem is the more you get bigger, all the big dollars get involved, and then everybody has a say in everything you do.
Right. Yeah.
Because at the beginning, nobody cares. It's like, oh, do whatever you want. We don't care.
Well, you've been around for years, so it doesn't really. really matter anyway. Everybody knows who you are. Yeah, so
I won't sell out. I won't play any of the crappy music.
Cool. That's cool.
And if I see stuff on MTV like every hour, I don't care how good the song is, I won't play it. Because it makes no sense to, you know, take a good piece of music and play it every hour after, you know, and then it just burns out the artist.
Then you can continue to play us because I don't think MTV is ever going to play us every hour. So keep going.
I thought they would on your latest song, though.
Everybody thought you can't figure MTV out, you know, whatever. It's like,
what can you do?
What can you do, exactly?
So that's why you're upset about the doing videos, right?
I just think that, you know, that the guy who did that, Phil Harder, that it's a great video, and it's kind of like, you know, I mean, that's as good as it's going to get. To me, it's like, all right, we can't do any better. This is as good as we can do. You know, if this isn't good enough, then I'm going to stop spending money on this, you know? Like, our sound guy has a saying, it's like, we could have bought a Porsche, you know? It's like, you know, come on, give me a break here.
Well, you know, all the money went for all the extras in your video. I mean, that crowd alone. I mean,
they look just like us, you know? Those guys are good.
Just to get the lookout, lookalikes, you know?
Yeah, it was tough, but those guys look, a lot of people, right? I never realized that many people look like us. It's really weird.
Well, I got my imposters running around, too, so you got to watch out.
They're everywhere.
Yeah, they're everywhere. Yeah. Let's see your latest video.
All right.
Yeah. All the kids are all right.
Right.
Right here on JBTV with Local H. Any other local bands you want to see?
You got a Fu Manchu sticker. They have a video?
Oh, yeah.
They do?
Yeah. It's like the kids get locked up and you never see these videos.
You never see it. Yeah. Is this on the latest record or?
Oh, you're asking me technical things like that? I have no clue.
Okay, but it's probably on the latest record.
Yeah.
No, I've never seen a Fu Manchu video.
Yeah. Well, what it is, they lock these kids in the school. I mean, no, the parents are doing like a meeting.
It's from...
I just watched that like a couple months ago.
On the Edge.
Yeah, On the Edge.
On the Edge. Uh-huh. That's what it is. So they burn them down in the school.
Well, you just lock them in, then they drive away or something. Or something like that.
It was Texas, right?
No, it was like a suburb in...
Texas.
Was it Texas?
Yeah.
It was Matt Dillon's first movie.
Yeah, it was Dallas.
Something like that.
Yeah.
I don't know. But that's a great movie. That's one of the greatest movies ever made. And the music in it is great. There's Cheap Trick music and old Van Halen music. And who else is in there? It's like
everybody's in there.
The Ramones. Yeah, it's really good.
Oh, yeah, Joey Ramone, he's been here too.
Oh,
He tells stories, like, he goes on and on. He's better than, like, you know, Howard Stern.
Joey loves to talk, man.
He's a cool guy,
He loves to talk. Joey's great.
When it was open back in the day, they played there, and me and him like hung out for like all night, just talking. He didn't want to hang with anyone, but I had to work. You know, I'm working. He's like, "Ah, come in, have a seat.
Let me tell you about my taxi cab ride."
He was cool. He had some stories.
Oh yeah. Okay.
So I want to see the Fu Manchu video then.
Okay.
Since it's a rip of the On the Edge, I want to totally see it. I'm down with that. That's cool.
Cool. Here it is right now on JBTV with Local H, and anyhow, stay tuned for a lot more. Now, during the show, the live show that you did, someone gave you a poster.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It said, some of us in Zion still loves you, blah, blah, you high-fiving motherfuckers or something.
Something like that.
So you get a lot of those at the shows, or?
Somebody had written something on a shirt in Milwaukee, said something about, you know, we think Zion sucks too, or something like that. And I mean, I don't want to, you know, I guess we hold this torch as that we hate Zion or something, but we don't, you know, it's just kind of like.
I mean, it's like everyone started twisting it, like we're saying Zion sucks.
I mean, just because you're frustrated with your hometown, you know, I don't think is necessarily unique.
Okay, although
you know,
it
happens everywhere.
We tried to play the band shell there probably two or three summers in a row, and they said no, the Park District. So. I mean, for that they suck because they don't want the kids to have any fun. Mm-hmm. It's based around old people, and they try to be conservative, and they're not. You know, they're not Lake Forest. They're not Highland Park. They try to be that way, and it's not that way. You know,
they never respect you. It seems like your own hometown. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You go all around the world, and people are gonna like what you do. But back when you go home, it's like this. Like there's something about it. I don't know. Like you know, I think they're just jealous that somebody got successful and left.
Well, even
it's
before,
kind of like local. Press.
Even before, it's just whatever. I mean, we hold no grudges. Yeah.
You know, it's just one of those places where there's really nothing there for you unless you're in high school or unless you're an old person. Like once you get out of high school, you got to get out.
Or
you're just gonna stay there and die.
Right.
But then the people we went to school with who are slagging us for slagging Zion, they say, who stayed there and you know, became clones. That's cool. They can do that. But, you know, hey, we're out and, you know, that's it. So
I don't think there's a kid there who disagrees with us, you know.
No, I know.
So exactly. Basically, there you go.
I've never been there. How far is that from Chicago here?
It's about an hour. It's like right, okay, you know how like, you know, it goes like this, Illinois?
Yeah.
Illinois goes like that. We're right there.
Right so in the corner like right on the there. Lake.
Uh-huh.
Border Wisconsin and Illinois.
Yeah.
Up top.
At Zion's hottest hits. So how is it going around to all these radio stations? You've done like hundreds of them by now.
Oh. I find that every time we go back, there's a new decoration or something.
Oh.
You know, new curtains, new blinds, something.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
New management, all that kind of stuff.
Familiarizing ourselves.
Well, radio's become like big corporate America.
Yeah, oh, it's yeah. really bad. It's you so know they bad. Just they just want to take away all of your choices.
And it's the
you know,
same.
They want to make it all for you.
I feel like a zombie when I go into them because it's the same thing every radio station. Although we had you know fun at the radio station the other day. You know, and it was...
Where was that?
It was, you know, relaxed and cool. You know, just a radio station in Chicago.
Oh.
And, you know, the big political thing.
Oh, yeah. That's like you had two sponsors, you know, on your right. at your show.
Right. When we go into
so the right side was one radio station, the left side was another.
So we try to, like, play two shows so one station can have one show and the other station can have the other.
There's no way we could play one show and then... You know, it'd be two. They'll probably drop both of us, or they'll drop us. You know, I mean, both stations. So
they'll drop both of us. Me and you. Not just me. You too.
So
it's gonna be hard doing the shows that way.
Yeah, it'll be tough.
Well, you'll have to have the sample vocals and guitar stuff,
yeah.
And you'll have the sampling drums.
Right. Oh yeah, totally into sampling. We're down.
In fact, you have to listen to the both radio stations to hear you both play together. No yeah, one's right, ever done right, that. Right. That'd be
blend
cool.
Blend it together?
Yeah.
Okay, you're playing them now? Yeah. Blend it. Yeah.
We'll see some more videos. What else do you guys want to see? Of yours or whoever, you know.
What else is there? What else do we got?
AC/DC, Scott? You didn't bring yeah.
AC/DC.
Anything you want.
Something really old from AC/DC or something. Do you have like
you know, like the one with Back in Black or whatever?
Yeah.
Is that the one?
Do you have Back
Is that
in
the
Black?
One with this you... cool looking chicks in this black leather?
No, I think that shook me all night. That shook me all night long.
Too. Oh, is it?
I don't want to see that one. That's,
oh, Sabbath, no, that's... Live Sabbath.
Do you have like for those about to rock?
I think so.
If you have the one with the cannons and they're like and they're going off,
we
that's cool.
We will rock you.
Man, that's Queen that
oh,
you don't
Queen.
That's Queen.
Oh, it's all blending together. Classic AC/DC right here on JBTV with Local H. The best. They're absolutely the best in the world. And, you know.
AC/DC.
You.
Oh, I thought you were talking
about
AC/DC.
I don't care about those other groups. So here's AC/DC, a little group, you know. I've never heard of them on
yeah,
JBTV.
Kids are all right. They got a good career ahead of them. I like them.
Yeah, they're going
they're cool. Yeah.
He's
got something. You know what? What other live-like things do you have? That's what we should... Playing.
I have all kinds of stuff.
I know. I saw some of it, but I couldn't, like, see it all.
Yeah.
I didn't see it all.
Well, I think we should play some live Local H right
okay.
here, right now. Any particular cuts? I got your set list now here.
All right. Let's see what we got here.
Now, you change this for every show, right?
No. We're going to change it tonight.
Uh-huh.
But
on the road, we don't really do two shows here or there, so it stays the same. It stays the same.
We played...
You played an extra song in between here,
we
too.
We played He's a Whore by Cheap Trick right there. That seemed like it was pretty good.
Well, let's see that.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. That's good. That'll be a gem.
Just play it all.
I love to.
Just play the whole
But what do I do about the swear words?
Hmm.
I don't really want to beep them.
Just play them.
Just beep them really
That's okay.
loudly. Beep them really loudly.
Yeah. Fade so I'll keep a little bit of the F. And a little bit of the K.
There
and the U and the U and the C will...
That's just me? What else would be good? Chuck.
Doesn't this look like a Saturday Night Live shot?
Yeah.
Doesn't look like... And now, Saturday Night Live.
Live from Chicago. But you've been on those shows. You've been on, like, Conan and all those shows already, right?
Yeah, we did Conan. We didn't do Saturday Night Live. I think you have to be a platinum artist.
You're not that yet?
Oh, no.
Your gold artists.
Well, we need to become platinum before we go in there.
Uh-huh.
And, you know.
See, people think we've sold a lot more records than we actually have. Exactly. We've only sold two records.
Really?
Yeah.
Three, Scott.
Oh, yeah. Your mom bought one, so. It hardly counts.
Well, you know, when the parents do it, you know.
When parents do it, you know, it's, they just buy one between them. You know, they don't like double up and do that kind of thing, which is what they should do. But
Michael Jackson had the best thing. You ship 100 million immediately.
Yeah.
And then, you know.
Then you just go, oh, okay, I'm platinum.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's an artist we'll never, ever play on this show. Like that Spice Girls. There are all these bands that I'll never play.
Oh, God, I ordered that movie on satellite the other day just for the hell of it.
Spice World? No way.
God, it was horrible. I couldn't even. It's worse than Godzilla. I tried to watch twice in the hotel room, and I just couldn't do it. It's so bad.
Yeah. You're determined to watch it. I'm determined to watch this thing. Gotta do it.
I mean, that's bad when a movie makes you just turn it. You know, it's just
especially after you pay for it. That's what I hate about pay-per-view, right. Because I'm a channel changer. You get in front of a TV, 10 seconds of anything. Okay, what's next? What's next? You know.
I think that sucks. That's, you know, it's kind of like, and then at 2:00, there's nothing on TV.
Yeah.
You know, and it's just like, I can't take it. I can't take TV anymore. And then they start selling you these things. And it's just like, when am I ever going to need this? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know, on our station, we got the Hair Club for Men and all these shows.
Yeah.
You know.
There you go.
And Jesus. Jesus is
That's
good.
Something you can use. Jesus and the Hair Club for Men. Those are two things which we all can get a little bit of.
Yeah. Well, in 20 years, you know, you may be calling them up.
Jesus or the Hair Club for Men?
Both of them.
Both of them.
He'll be running the Hair Club for Men.
He should. He's got a head of hair on him.
Only 5 more.
And then what?
In our career.
No. Are you going to get some time off now? Are you on a constant touring?
No.
Or?
Is our manager named Steve Smith? No, of course not.
We're actually leaving tomorrow. Tonight's supposed to be the end of the tour, but we're leaving tomorrow.
Tomorrow to play a show Saturday in L.A.
Uh-huh.
Then Tuesday in New York. Then Saturday or Friday, Double Door. Then Saturday, New Orleans.
Yeah. Wow.
Then Australia. So.
Well, Australia, Midnight Oil.
Yes. And we played with them last year.
Yeah, we did play with Midnight Oil actually.
Festival.
Yeah.
Tool and Midnight Oil.
And yeah. Peter Garrett, he is so cool.
They had a big, like, oversized Hummer. It wasn't a Hummer. It was like a big, real Jeep, big Army Jeep. Remember that thing was sitting there?
No.
Yeah, anyway, they was sitting there, and he brought his kids or whatever, and they were all hanging out in it, climbing. But it was this big old, like, army tank that they had sitting there. I was like, whose is that? They're like, Midnight Oil. Oh, it's a tour bus.
Well, Peter Garrett, he's like a politician. He's like a, you know.
Maybe. You know, I would never call him cool. He's way too hyper to be cool. Yeah, the guy's just a freak.
Isn't he kind of like Mario from Stanford?
He's a lot like Mario, the band who we're playing with, Stanford Prison Experiment. He's... Uh-huh.
You got their video play.
Yes, I think we should play it because that's a video that doesn't get any airplay. And you're going to see it right here, right now on JBTV. Stay tuned for a lot more with Local H. So you guys have fun. Anything we didn't cover that?
What haven't we covered?
So I didn't ask any of those normal questions. How is it not having more than 2 people play?
Where are you from, Zion? Now, how did you do the bass thing? I'm tired of that crap.
The sound you guys get, though, just the two of you, is just amazing.
Thanks.
You know,
Scott turns up and he's pissing our sound man off and our tech, but he doesn't care. That's all right.
You know, when in doubt, just volume, basically. It overcomes
everything.
Yeah.
You don't hear the creaking of the foot pedal. Uh-huh. You don't hear any of those things. Remember, you know,
it makes up for my shortcomings, basically, is volume. I don't have to really be that good. I just turn it up really loud.
Well, now that they have channel 11 or whatever it is on the volume controls, you know?
Oh, yeah.
11, 10, you know, Spinal 11. Tap, whatever. I don't know.
Oh, I totally know Spinal Tap.
That was a good movie.
It's an excellent movie.
Yeah.
It's a great
Sometimes
movie.
Sometimes it seems too true.
It gets funnier and funnier. It's kind of painful. It's getting a little painful.
Yeah. Well, thanks again for being on the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
You know, you're always so nice. Welcome here. And it's just, you know, I wish it would have came sooner. But again, the music speaks for itself, you know. Right. And to me, I like to always just like the music, you know. Because
at the end of the day, that's what counts.
Yeah.
You got to be on the same page.
Same page.
As long as everyone's on the same page at the end of the day, it's your record.
Right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
Okay, well, there we go. Another edition of JBTV, your alternative show from downtown Chicago. Let's see, we had videos and a lot more, live concert footage, all here with Local H. And we're going to give your latest CD away, which we're going to show.
Excellent.
And to a few selected people, although we got the selected, the one that says, you know, not for sale, promotional use only. all that kind of stuff. But
well, that should be the cover of our next record.
Now, you know,
it's
the bird is flicking
that.
The cat off. You just have to.
Oh,
look.
Really?
You have to look close.
Wow, and you didn't get a parental advisory.
No.
The bird is flipping him the bird.
And that cat's going, mm, mm, mm.
That cat's going, hey, dude, don't flip me the bird. Come on, give me a break here.
Yeah.
I'm just a cat. I'm just hanging around. All I want to do is talk. What's up? Yeah.
So here it is. Pack Up the Cats. Their latest CD. And you can get it at Crow's Nest Music, the collector's choice.
And we touched it.
Please buy it.
Yeah. Now they don't want it.
Oh.
Okay.
Cool.
All
right. Well, there we go. Stay tuned next Wednesday night right here on Channel 62 for another great edition of JVTV. It's going to be part two with Local H. Because you deserve, I'm going to give you so much airtime that MTV is going to say, why haven't we had these guys on more often?
You know what? When you do show the interview, every time we say MTV, you should like bleep it out.
Bleep it.
Bleep it out as a bad word.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Just do that.
So
just.
Here we go. Let's try it. Okay. MTV, bleep.
Okay.
M bleep. Yeah. You do the bleep, I do the MTV. Ready?
Okay.
MTV.
Bleep.
Yeah. There you go.
Uh-huh. Let me try one more time.
All right. MTV.
Bleep. Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4. MTV. Bleep. Okay.
They're just one bleeping good network.
And we can't say the F word. Why should we be able to say the M word?
Yeah.
I don't think we should.
Yeah. So you want to see a little bit of the show?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes, we totally do.
This is right at the beginning. You start out a little dark, but it brightens up. This is unedited. I'm still working on
it. Yeah, that's cool.
So.
Must be 500,000.
It's all right, yeah.
All right, oh yeah.
There's my camera. What a great show.
Thanks. Sounds good.
And you can remix it if you want for the show.
Sounds pretty good.
And we'll sync it all back up and everything, so. Looks a little dark because of lights. It's more like that there. There's good-looking female photographer running around, too.
Oh, Mary.
Did you see? Oh, you know who
yeah,
she is?
She did our album.
Oh.
Blonde.
She was right by me in the camera there, and she's, like, bending down, and I'm, like, looking at her instead of shooting you for a minute, so.
Stuff up and down.
Huh? Oh, this isn't even an edit, this is just screwing around. The crowd was a little dark though, there weren't a lot of lights on them, so. This goes on for 90 minutes.
Cool.
So we can have you sign this for us?
Yeah. You know, my mom likes the F word, and so it's okay. Uh-huh. It's all right. Yeah.
So she said this while you were growing up.
What, the F word? No, actually, she would never. That would never come out of her mouth. You know, and it's just like she had a thing about it. So that's probably why.
Why it's in the song.
Yeah. Why it's in every damn song we have.
And then back when I had my access show, you know, the high five and motherfucker is the one we played, you know. But now that we're on broadcast, we can't say motherfucker anymore, you know.
Well, you know, I kind of like bleeps. You know, there's a good.
But it's just something about screwing with the music in any way, shape, or form that gets me upset a little, you know.
Well, I kind of like the fact that there's, you know, I mean, if you want to listen to it the way it is, you've got the record. But, I mean, we all know the FCC and we all know, you know, what words you can't say, so there's no reason to really complain about it, you know. If you want to really hear the real one, there's a record.
Mm-hmm. It's like your, it's a high five, the one at the end with your, like, going for the money.
Yes.
It's like right at the end of the video, it's like, okay, everybody else got it.
What was his name, Dr. Winkles?
Dr. Winky.
Winky, whatever.
Who was that? That was the guy in the
video?
That
was the guy with the money, with the briefcase.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It was his club
His club and his real money. He went to the bank and got like $100,000 out or something, or $20,000 or something, and put it in his briefcase.
That wasn't fake money.
That weren't Monopoly money.
Oh no. You know, that's against law. You can't do that. That's
Monopoly money.
No, real money. You're not supposed to show it on TV.
Really?
So, you know.
Is that true?
I heard that, but why is that?
I don't know.
We were just kidding. It's Monopoly money.
You're not supposed to have real beer on TV?
Yeah.
What is that about?
I don't know. Well, that's inside this Coke is really a beer.
You have to drink, pretend you're drinking Coke.
Yeah, that's it.
That's what they do on Friends, right?